Global snack giant Mondelez International sees the Philippines as among the fastest growing markets for snacks and beverages. Despite this, the company is not yet keen on manufacturing its products in Manila for now. Here's an excerpt of Cathy Ang's exclusive interview with Mondelez Chairman and CEO Dirk Van De Put.
The growth of snacking around the world in the coming 5 to 10 years will be largely coming from the developing markets, about 80% of it. And then if you start thinking developing markets, Southeast Asia and the Philippines in particular are going to be a major growth factor for us. So I want to keep close to what's going on and talk to our teams, talk to the consumers, see our clients.
Why
and
the
make
Philippines?
Sure, if you think about this globally, we're the number one in biscuits, we're number one in chocolate, and so we have a big opportunity here in the Philippines to grow, so that's one of the reasons to come. I would say for us at this moment, we feel that the business climate in the Philippines is pretty good.
How much better? What's improved over the past 3 years since the administration came in?
I would say more easiness of doing business, more stability in the country. I think the consumer is quite optimistic. So we've seen double-digit growth last year. We are seeing single-digit growth this year. So those are significant numbers for us.
And the per capita income, I mean, has that seen growth? We're having a lot more millennials going to the working population, a lot more spending power. How does that all add up to the robustness of the Philippine market for your company?
I mean, the market is quite robust. It's one of our bigger markets in the world. It's seen the size of the country, it's substantial for us. We're seeing good growth. The per capita consumption is going up slightly, I would say. Overall, our feeling is that it is a market that we want to invest in for the future because we see the right business climate, the right consumer. Snacking in the Philippines is quite important. As I understand it, people eat about 6 meals or in between meals a day. So it's already a very fertile market for a snacking company.
What are the plans of actually producing them here?
But at this stage, we do not have the plans to do that. I would say the business would need to become bigger before we can do that. But at the same time, it is produced within Southeast Asia, which we consider as sort of a trading region. We have 10 plants in the area here, so we feel that we are able to supply the region from those 10 plants.
Catch Cathy Ang's full interview on The Boss, July 4 at 7:30 in the evening, only here on ANC.